Hello and welcome back. In this video, we will see how we can automatically generate C code from the classification model we built before in MATLAB and deploy it on a real piece of hardware. In particular, what we'll do, we will first validate our algorithm on the desktop to see if it performs well. And then, you know, once we make sure that this works well, we can automatically generate code from it and test it on a PLC. So let me just show you exactly what we're going to do next. So we're going to start from this model. And then what we will do, we will automatically generate code from the classification algorithm that we will bring into Simulink through a MATLAB function block. So what we do, we just leverage code generation and we deploy the algorithm on a PLC. So after this, instead of testing this algorithm directly with the real piece of hardware, with the real Flowpak machine, what we do, we actually test this against a real-time representation of the model. And in particular, what we do, we deploy the plant model and the controller on a Speedgoat machine. And this Speedgoat machine essentially will represent the real-time behavior of the model. And in this way, by connecting the Speedgoat and the PLC through an Ethernet power link connection, the algorithm running on the PLC actually thinks that is being tested against the real piece of hardware. Okay, so let me show you exactly what this looks like. So here we have the PLC, where we will deploy the classification algorithm. And then here you can see the Ethernet power link connection. And this is connected to the Speedgoat machine. And on the Speedgoat machine, we will deploy the Simulink model that represents the Flowpak machine. So all of this is basically made possible through Simulink real-time. So Simulink real-time is a tool that allows us to quickly and very easily run any Simulink model in real-time on a real-time machine. And also what we can do with Simulink real-time is leverage MATLAB APIs. In particular, we can build a GUI with App Designer, like in this case, and then quickly use it to test algorithms in real-time. So here we start the real-time simulation, and then we can see how the signals are collected in real-time. And here we can watch the desired position in blue and the actual position in red on the first plot. And then we also measure the torque produced at the shaft, and then the speed of the motor. So we also have a couple of scalar values for the failures on the mechanical side and the electrical side. And then essentially what we can do from here, from this app, we can inject faults in the model. So for instance, what we can do, we can inject a fault on the electrical side, and then we can immediately see how this impacts the behavior of the Flowpak machine. So we can watch this in the GUI, and then we can see how now we have a red lamp for the electrical failure. And this means that the algorithm that is now running on the PLC and that was deployed directly from Simulink is actually behaving well and is capable of spotting a failure on the electrical side. So once again, before we switch to MATLAB, let me just recap. So here on the PLC, we are running the classification algorithm. And here on the Speedgoat machine, we are running the plant model. So that being said, let's see how we actually achieve this. Okay, so here we are in Simulink. So what we see here, we see exactly the same model that we used before to generate data. And then here we have added another subsystem. In this subsystem, we will perform the fault detection. So if we go inside, we have a couple of variants. So let's take a look at the first one. So in this one, we have a MATLAB function. And with this MATLAB function, what we do, we perform, first of all, features extraction from the data that we measure during simulation. Then we normalize it. And then we perform prediction. So we load the model that we have built before with the classification learner app. And then we call the predict function that gives us the label for the fault condition that is predicted. Okay, and then we also have another variant, which is the real-time variant. And then, as you can see here, we don't have any MATLAB function block, but we simply manage the communication between the Speedgoat machine, where the plant model runs, and the PLC, where the classification algorithm runs. Okay. So instead of injecting faults directly from the Simulink model, we can use an app. And in particular, this app was built with App Designer. And it's a very convenient way to essentially control Simulink models, and in this case, modify parameters, inject faults, plots, and so on. So for example, from here, we can inject faults, we can switch from desktop to real-time simulation, we can watch possible failures of our system, and so on. So if we start the simulation, we can see how classification algorithm behaves. So essentially what we are doing now, we are just testing the classification algorithm that we have built before with the classification learner app. And we want to see how this behaves on the desktop. So we want to see how this behaves in Simulink. So at the beginning, we have no faults. And so we'll have green lights, both on the electrical side and on the mechanical side. So as the simulation goes on, we can just start to inject failures. So for example, what we do here, we just decrease the gearbox efficiency, and then we can see that we have a yellow lamp for the mechanical failure. So this means that the classification algorithm is actually doing okay at spotting this kind of failure. But we can further, make things worse. And then we can actually further reduce the efficiency of the gearbox. And then, we can see whether the algorithm is able to spot this. And then after a bit of seconds, after the features are extracted and the prediction is done, we can see that we have a red lamp on the mechanical failure. Okay, so at this point, we are confident that the model works well on the desktop, so we can generate code from it. So first of all, let's open a new project in Automation Studio, which is the IDE to program B&R PLCs. Let's select the hardware that we can use. And then let's go back to Simulink. So at this point, you will recognize that here we have exactly the same MATLAB function block that we have tested before on the desktop. And then all we need to do is just map the Simulink signals to variables in Automation Studio. So here we use these blocks from the B&R target for Simulink. And then here we select whether we want to generate C or C++ code, if we want to use Simulink coder or embedded coder. Then we give a name to the task that we'll generate, select the hardware, and then we point to the project that we previously created. So at this point, we only need to build the model. And once we do this, we essentially use embedded coder to automatically generate C code from the classification algorithm. So once we click on OK and close this, we will see that the code has been automatically imported in Automation Studio. And here, what I want to point out is that we don't need to use necessarily this kind of target. We could use any other supported target, as for example, Siemens or Backoff, or we could simply generate NC standard C code and import this into another embedded system. So, you know, from Simulink, we are quite independent on the hardware chosen. Okay, so at this point, after deploying the code on the PLC, we can just run the algorithm in real time. And once we switch from desktop to real time, we are essentially changing the variant for the fault classification that I showed you before. So at this point, we connect to the Speedgoat machine, and then we build a model. So what we're doing now, we are just generating again C code from the Simulink model, but now from the plant. And this code will be automatically deployed on the Speedgoat machine. So to do this, we just click on download. And then now we are ready to run the algorithm in real time. So, you know, since the Speedgoat is connected to the PLC, where we have recently deployed code for the classification algorithm, we're essentially now testing the real-time behavior of the classification algorithm, and we are testing how the C code is behaving in real time. So instead of testing this directly with the real Flowpack machine, it is very convenient to run this against the real-time representation of the Flowpack machine itself. And this is because now we can inject faults in the model without actually breaking the real physical system. And this is very useful to test the classification algorithm on the PLC. And as you can see now, also here in real time, the C code that is running on the PLC is actually behaving well and is capable of spotting the failure on the mechanical side. And then once again, we can further make things worse. We can just inject faults in the model without breaking the actual physical system. And then we can see that the model works well. So this brings us to the end of the predictive maintenance workflow for the condition monitoring aspect. So in the next videos, we will actually take a step back and then we will go back to the train model part, and then we will see how we can use the condition indicators to build a different kind of algorithm. In particular, instead of building a classification algorithm, we will use a different model to estimate how much time we have before the bearing system might fail. So we will take a look at prognostics and remaining useful life estimation.